Henry, that man in the pawn shop done give me $10 on my watch, and now I can buy Liza something for her birthday and send it to her. That's what's been worrying me.
You done spent the whole lunchtime we had here in the pawn shop. That whistle gonna blow any minute now. We gotta get back to work on this here building.
Well, Liza's got a birthday day after tomorrow, and I had to send her something. And if I didn't have no money, then the next best thing to do is to get her something. And I'm gonna send her something pretty, too.
Is you gonna spend the whole $10 for her birthday present?
I ought to spend more than that, Henry, but I ain't got it. And if I don't send her a birthday present, one of them boys down there in Birmingham is liable to beat my time.
We just got about 10 more minutes before the whistle blows to go back to work. Let's walk over to the store here and get a sandwich.
I don't care, Henry. I'll go with you.
Let's walk fast now. We ain't got much time.
Just a minute. What's your name?
Is you talking to me, mister? My name is Sam Smith.
You're the feller I'm looking for, all right. You're working on this building here, aren't you?
Yes, sir, mister. He's working on the building here.
You're the feller, all right. Now, the Indefinite Life Insurance Company of Cincinnati, Ohio, sent me here to see you.
Who sent you here, mister?
The Indefinite Life Insurance Company of Cincinnati, Ohio.
What has Sam done now, mister?
The records of the United States government show that you are not protected, and according to the laws of this country, every man must have protection. Do you realize what it would mean if somebody would accidentally hit you on the head with a hammer? Picture yourself laying in bed with a broken head and probably one leg off, without a dime at the mercy of charity and your stomach hungry for food. That is the most terrible predicament a human being can be in.
The gentleman is right, Sam. The gentleman is right.
Now then, I have a policy here that in case of your death, your nearest relative will receive $500 cash immediately upon your death.
I don't think he got no relatives, mister.
And then here is a clause right here that should interest you. Should you lose one eye and one leg, you get $200. Should you lose both eyes and one leg, you get $250. Should you lose both legs and both eyes, you get $300. Should you lose both legs, both eyes, and one arm, you get $350. And should this condition cause you to die, your beneficiary gets the difference between the amount paid you and $500.
Suppose he just breaks his beneficiary.
That don't matter about that part. My eyes is the most important part.
How much it costs, mister?
The premium is only 10 cents a week. Now, I only have a short time, and the Indefinite Life Insurance Company of Cincinnati, Ohio, only has a limited number of these policies. Now, how do you spell your last name?
He spells it S-M-I-T-H, mister.
And your first name is Sam. Ah, there you are. You're all set.
Let me ask you one question here, mister. When do I collect this here money in case something happens to me?
Your labor council immediately notifies us of your accident, and we rush to your bedside with the cash. And now you can work and feel that you are fully protected by the Indefinite Life Insurance Company of Cincinnati, Ohio.
10 cents a week ain't much, Sam.
Well, that's all right then, mister. I'll take it.
Pay the man. Go ahead. Pay the man.
Now, the initial payment on this is $10 and 10 cents a week after that.
How much is it, mister?
$10 is the initial payment.
I didn't think it was that much.
Pay the man. You got $10 in your pocket.
I don't care then, mister. I'll take it. Here you is, mister.
Thank you very much. Now, how about one for you?
No, sir, mister. I ain't got no money. Come around and see me some other time.
There's the whistle blowing, Henry. We gotta get back to work, boy.
Well, boys, I'll see you again.
Yes, sir, mister. Goodbye.
Come on. Let's get back to work here.
Doggone, Henry. I done spent that money for Liza's birthday present. What is I gonna tell Liza?
Well, that's the Indefinite Life Insurance Company, ain't it?
Mm-hmm.
Just tell her that her birthday present is indefinite.